Hello and good evening, everyone. Thank you all for participating in Bootcamp 1.0. I would like to start this session by requesting Professor Banerjee, Director of GLA Business School, to welcome all the participants and proceed with the session. Over to you, Professor Banerjee.
Thank you, Shubhadeep. Hello, friends. I hope all of you are in good health and high spirit in such an extraordinary time in our life. I welcome everyone in this e-bootcamp program, which is specially designed for the startup entrepreneurs and MSMEs. This e-bootcamp is a part of our Pan-India initiative on innovation and entrepreneurship development. In this direction, we initiated two programs, Innovation Studio and Startup Launchpad, ISSLP, and WI, Women Innovation and Startup Hub. Both the programs shall be supported by different ministries of central government, such as Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Atal Innovation Mission under Niti Aayog, BIDAC, Department of Biotechnology, Startup India under Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India, as well as many higher education institutions such as CSIR, CD, PIT, IIT Delhi, amongst others. The National Startup Bootcamp 1.0, as a part of ISSLP and WISH, is as of now scheduled on 10th of July in Delhi. However, under this COVID-19 situation, it seems to be very unlikely that whether we will be allowed to make any such big gathering in next few months. Hence, we decided to organize a few boot camps with the startup founders in small batches in the meantime. I'm happy to announce that in the first batch, we received participants from 10 different states across the country. We wanted to restrain the number to maximum 30 in any batch so that we can give personal attention to each of the participants. However, due to this overwhelming response, we are bound to make this batch size slightly bigger. In this particular batch, we have 47 participants, including 6 women candidates from almost all regions across the country. We are receiving more applications every day. They shall be accommodated in the next batch, which is going to be started in the mid-June. The target audience can be divided in 2 different categories: startups from 0 to 2 years of their age and MSMEs who are more than 2 years old but less than 5 years. We will shortlist participants from such e-bootcamp programs for our national bootcamp program. With the finally selected candidates, after all such boot camps, we will draw a long-term plan to make this journey together. I thank you all for joining with us. I request you to attend all the online classes over the next 4 weeks. Trust me, it is going to be a great experience for all of us. With this brief opening note, I hand over to Professor Shubhadeep Das for next proceeding. Thank you, everyone. Shubhadeep, you may please proceed.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Now, can I please request Professor Lopamudra Bhattacharya, the founder and CEO of JLL Business School, for her address and discuss the WISH program for the women entrepreneurs. Over to Professor Lopamudra Bhattacharya. Ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Das. Good evening to all of you. I'll basically discuss on the program, a mission we have taken that is called WISH. What is WISH? WISH is a Women Innovation and Startup Hub. I think there are so many women are in this e-boot camp. So basically, I'm focusing this mission for them, but others can join. What is WISH? WISH is a desire, hope, or longing for something or for something to happen. It is an expression of such a desire. The process of expressing or thinking about such a desire, which often connected with ideas of magic and supernatural powers. This WISH program has been designed to provide women entrepreneurs with a need-based intervention model to help them scale up. It will include women entrepreneurs from across the socioeconomic strata, geographical borders, and operational capacities. The focus sector are FMCG, manufacturing, healthcare, fintech, edtech, and e-commerce. Basically, WISH is a platform. It is a platform of developing and implementing programs for promotion of entrepreneurship and incubating women-owned startup across India. The project dares to ask, what would we contribute if we need to foster a richer and diverse startup and ecosystem for female adventure? There are some noises are coming. So WISH mission is to create its own micro ecosystem at different places across India and provide a platform for women startups that can solve the local problems using breakthrough technology. This platform, by fulfilling its mission, would contribute to job creation and enhancing the socioeconomic health to the region. WISH, this is a platform. It basically focuses primarily on young women startups from college campuses. The team works towards searching of talent pool and women entrepreneur and encourages them to build a startup, launching it within a time frame. We will focus on concept stage women entrepreneurs, and through our mentoring programs, we will help them to convert raw ideas into strong business plans. WISH aims to incubate 1,000 startups over next 5 years that are women-owned. This initiative is believed will go a long way in helping to transform women positively towards better life and society through economic development. I believe nothing is impossible without the participation of women entrepreneurs from different economic and social strata. I call for joining with us with your WISH to do something great in your life through business. We shall be always with you to hold your hands and thanking you all for your patience, for listening me, and our JLF team will always be with you, basically, especially for women who are now sharing this e-boot camp within this group. Thanking you all. Now I'm handing over to Professor Shubhadeep Das. Thanks, Shubhadeep, for giving me a chance.
Thank you, madam, for the insight. Once again, I would like to request Professor Abhijit Banerjee, Director of JLL Business School, to please explain to the participants how they will be benefited through this program. We will not be holding the question and answer session today due to lack of time. But I would request all of you to have, those who have questions with them, to please note them down and we will individually address to all of them on a later session. Over to you, Professor Banerjee.
Professor Lopamudra Bhattacharya, the founder and CEO of the Relay Business School, in her address explained the objective of OIST program for the women entrepreneurs. I'm happy that women entrepreneurs are enthusiastically participating in our program. COVID-19 pandemic has posed a big threat to all the startups and MSMEs. All are very scared and public. No one is in a position to assess directly what is actually going to be the impact of this lockdown in their business. However, I believe personally, everything is not dark. Excepting a few cases, the crisis is also creating big opportunities for the future for most of the MSMEs. Many multinational companies shall refuse to continue from China and soon will look for a destination to shift their manufacturing base, which I was predicting from the very early stage of this crisis. As we understood from different sources, Government of India is sincerely working on this, and the embassies are taking initiatives to coordinate in proper channels. Government has taken short, medium, and long-term measures to solve the issues and declared economic rebooting package and reform measures. This is a high time for the MSMEs to realize these opportunities in disguise. The main objective of this e-book camp is to empower the startups and MSMEs. You should learn how to mitigate the present risk and explore those opportunities arising out of this global health disaster. This e-book camp program will cover the key aspects such as innovation, new business models and strategy, market, resources and finance, and sustainable growth through partnership. Next. Next slide. Indian economy is at a crossroads. Government has set a target of $5 trillion economy. But the reality is, India's GDP before this crisis was estimated at around $2.8 trillion. In the last fiscal, the GDP growth dipped to an 11-year low of only 5%. This is estimated that the present COVID situation will bring it down to less than 2%. So this is the economic condition as of now. Next slide. India is right now standing at a strategic inflection point. At this critical moment, country can choose to pull back, retrench, and focus on old world business model, or can choose to move forward, invest in the future, and accelerate entrepreneurship. PM Modi's clarion call to Atmanirbhar Bharat and recent economic rebooting packages and the reforms declared by Honorable Finance Minister give a clear indication that government prefers to follow the new economy model in future. Technology innovation is essential to drive the growth. It is the key to introduction of a new or improved product, process, or methods, competitiveness, and employment. Innovation has to be actively encouraged and supported in India as it continues to accelerate around the world. India must have to act now at this current strategic inflection point. It will surely give dividends in future. Next. Yes. United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, in its recent report, showed that the small businesses collectively can also bring economic growth. The concept of sustainable development links three dimensions of sustainability. One, economic, second, social, and third, environmental. 2030 agenda emphasizes the unity of and mutual support between all these three dimensions. UNCTAD has long emphasized the importance of economic structural transformation to poverty eradication and long-term development. Structural transformation refers to the transfer of production factors, particularly land, labor, and capital, from activities and sectors with low productivity and value added to those with higher productivity and value added, which are typically different in location and organization, as well as technological. This process allows an economy to continually generate new dynamic activities characterized by higher productivity and greater efficiency. Entrepreneurs can make an important contribution to structural transformation in several ways. Firstly, it is an important mechanism for shifting productive resources from economic activities with low value-added productivity to a high value-added productivity, whether in agriculture, industry, or service. Secondly, it can stimulate investment and contribute to building a knowledge-driven economy, which plays a central role in its economic growth. Thirdly, even for any unviable innovation, food, services, production technologies, or business models, which are new to a particular setting, may provide valuable information for future entrepreneurial decisions, including those of other entrepreneurs in the form of cost discovery. Next. Next slide. Yes. The relentless parade of new technologies is unfolding on many fronts. Not even emerging technology will alter the business or social landscape, but some innovations truly have the potential to disrupt the status quo, to alter the way people live and work, and to rearrange the value pool. It is therefore critical that business and policy leaders understand which technologies will matter to them and prepare accordingly. Disruptive technologies have the power to transform life business and the global economy. In a 2018 report from the McKinsey Global Institute, they identified 12 technologies that could drive truly massive economic transformation and disruptions in the coming years. According to the data from Sid McKinsey study, a dozen technologies, including genomics, energy storage, and automation, will drive major economic and societal transformation in the next several years. The value of emerging technologies could constitute 1/3 of global GDP with a potential economic impact between $14 trillion and $33 trillion a year in 2025. As India embraces such technology-driven economy, our academic institutions must change themselves. While we retain our core mission of education and educating the next generation, cultivating new forms of knowledge, higher education institutions must embrace overexpanding role in driving innovation and catalyzing as the agent for economic development. Next. An innovation ecosystem is made of different actors, relationships, and resources that all play a role in taking a great idea to a transformative impact at scale. The effectiveness of each part within the innovation ecosystem is moderated by other parts of the system. The change to one part of the innovation ecosystem leads to change in other part of the innovation ecosystem. Innovation ecosystems can operate at multiple levels and within multiple sectors. The four basic elements of the innovation ecosystem comprises of people, policy, process, and climate. Next. Ecosystems are not built in short time. They are built over decades. Silicon Valley startup ecosystem has been working on it since 1970s. A fine-tuned machine after 40 years of optimization. Startup ecosystems are popping up all across the country in India with varying levels of success. The mix of ingredients needed to make a startup ecosystem is thriving over time. The blueprint to propel startup ecosystem at local level shall lead to success in the process. Collaboration between all startup stakeholders with a shared set of common goals are the preconditions to build such a robust startup ecosystem. Next. Partnership Continuum Project, the breadth of partnership possibilities, reflecting the way in which many of the forms of interactions are interconnected. Partnership continuum as a model can be used to explain how academia, industry, society, and government interact across the spectrum of partnership modes. This continuum will stimulate others to extend their current concepts regarding the meaning of partnership and identify new ways to partnering with others to the maximum benefit of all involved in the network. Next. Next slide, please. Yeah. The nation ahead, next slide, please. Yeah. The nation ahead program of GLS Business School aims to become a catalyst of building a robust ecosystem that will integrate all the stakeholders. In this ecosystem, academia will be at the center of innovation and startup. Thus, it will work towards the acceleration of regional economic growth through partnership between different stakeholders. Next. In order to meet the need of the startups and MSMEs, GLS Business School is working on a unique model of partnership by integrating all the resources and stakeholders which is actually missing in India. It will build a self-sufficient system under one umbrella. From this slide, you can see that at the center, there is transformational entrepreneurship cluster where the community network business hub will be integrated with common production and selling facilities for the MSME. The objective of this activity is broader improvements in quality of life and to bolster the fiscal sustainability, which is supported by four pillars. So this central activity is the activity which our system will facilitate and the entrepreneurs will execute. And it is supported by four different pillars which the system will provide. The pillar one is disruptive technology for R&D and innovation center. The objective is to improve the competitiveness. Focus is product process quality design, four aspects. Pillar two is disruptive strategy. Here I would like to mention that we speak about disruptive technology, but rarely we speak about disruptive strategy, which is essential for the success. Here the system will have management development center aiming at improving the competitiveness. Focus is cost competitiveness, customer value proposition, business model, and the functional efficacy of the startups and MSMEs. Pillar three will focus on marketing. The system will have its own market research center. The aim is to show the strength in the market. Whatever product you have, whatever the quality of the product you have, if you fail to establish it in the market, then there is no meaning. And the focus will be on brand equity, deciding, decoding the consumer behavior, market selection, managing distribution, and promotion. The fourth pillar is the most crucial pillar, capital. There will be own business finance center aiming at ensuring the flow of money to MSMEs and the startup firms. The focus will be long-term and short-term funding from different sources. And it will be done through partnership. And the major partners, the major stakeholders will be the educational institutions, will be the ecosystem funders, including government, the Chamber of Commerce, and the media, who will actually propagate your success stories so that the others are encouraged to join. Next. Next, please. Working together is the need of this hour. Economy of scale does matter in market, especially to compete with big corporate houses and multinationals. The corporatization of startups and MSMEs can only be done through mutual partnership, as I explained earlier. We have identified 10 different business verticals where the startups and MSMEs across the country can join hands to become complementary or supplementary or both to each other. Growth in a shorter tenure is the urgent need of present time. The partnership with each other and forming conglomeration can give you a real strength with minimum risk on the individual entity. Next. Both myself and Professor Bhattacharya explained ISSLP and WISH. These both are, next please. These both are innovation and incubation program of GLA Business School that is aimed at building a self-reliant ecosystem for the startups and MSMEs in accordance with the vision of our Nation Ahead program. Next. Global, next, earlier slide please, earlier slide please. Global economic crisis has increased the urgency for India to identify new sources of growth and to develop a sustainable path for economic success. Traditional reliance on natural resources becomes insufficient to support the long-term growth. Economic globalization and advances in technology significantly increase market competitiveness. Product life cycles are shorter, production costs are lower, and market demand change faster than before. The startups and MSMEs should understand this environment of business. The challenges posed by different factors and the business risks. You should plan for your resource constraint, including qualified manpower and capital, very professionally to cope up with this situation. Next. India needs to use technology to facilitate rapid development and distribution of new products and services to the global marketplace. Market and types of innovation are two essential factors to be considered carefully while commercializing the technology innovation. Startup entrepreneurs should not ignore the relationship between different types of innovation and market. You must plot your product in this matrix to develop your business model and right business strategy. Next. The process of commercialization from innovation to a successful business involves three essential building blocks divided in three broad phases. Every step of the process induces development of complex business models and strategies. We shall discuss everything during our sessions, technical sessions, in next 4 weeks. Next, please. We are keen to know from the participants their business specific issues. We will try our level best to give you some direction. I would like to request you to write to us on any particular business problem that you are facing. We will definitely try to address it. The technical sessions will be scheduled soon and will be communicated to you. And believe me, it is going to be a very interesting one. You all should participate. We are trying to make it in the evening from 7 to 8 tentatively. If you have any suggestion to us, just let us know before we announce the schedule. I believe the evening time is convenient for all of us to participate in such a program. And definitely, I welcome you all again to this transformational venture. It's really going to be a transformational venture for all the participants. Thank you very much for hearing me. And I'm handing over to Professor Shubhadip Das for next process.
Thank you, sir, for the detailed and in-depth explanation of the whole session. I would request Professor Banerjee and Professor Bhattacharya to publish their white paper, which will be shared later on through social media or through the WhatsApp group. Okay, now closing the session, I would like to thank and I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude towards the speakers today, Professor Banerjee and Professor Bhattacharya, for taking out time for this session. I would also like to thank everyone who managed to join today. And for those who haven't been able to join, a video of the whole session will be made available shortly to our digital team. As Professor Banerjee previously mentioned, everything will be communicated either through WhatsApp, and we are very keen to hear from all of you about your queries, and we will be very glad if we can totally support your venture, and would also like to thank all the participants for attending the Bootcamp 1.0. Thank you. Stay safe. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Shubhadip, and thank you all for joining with us.